Yo, what's good, man? So listen, right now I'm at the Crypto King house, man. Just touched down in South America. Y'all stay tuned, man. We got a dope interview on the way. Sit right here. Welcome,
Crypto. Welcome to Crypto. That's what it is.
The crypto.
All this week, Chris.
Yes, sir. Crypto King, man. Bitcoins. You feel me? That's it. Live interview. Live interview.
Bitcoin. Crypto.
Okay, so this is guest room right here. This is where pretty much income is. Man, it's dope right here, man.
Yeah, you know, that's why Bitcoin, man. You made Bitcoin, this is the best thing. Bitcoin is the best thing, man. I'm telling you.
That's real. That's real. Live and direct from the Crypto King. You feel me?
Hey.
Been dealing with currency since 2009, but when you say you started in
2010, because, you know, I started investigating, that was the best.
In 2010?
2010, yeah.
Got you. And your facilities, man, all through South America.
Oh, yeah. I've been in that. You know, I like Venezuela more because the electricity is real cheap to invest in, you know, the crypto, you know.
Definitely. But you know, the thing is, man, like.
For farming is the best thing, Venezuela.
Definitely. And Pedro told me, man, like, you help a lot of people over there in Venezuela, far as with jobs when the economic crisis hit in 2009.
Yes, I be helping people there. I have many friends in Venezuela, Colombia, Peru, in Ecuador, Chile, and here in DR, you know. But I be traveling a lot, you know. That's why I met you.
Definitely. So, y'all, what's happening? She live interview with the Crypto King. Yo, listen, the Crypto King gonna break this down, tell you his story. I'm gonna ask him some questions, get some answers. You feel me? So check it out, man. The first question I wanna ask you, man, when it came to Bitcoins, man, what got you into investing in Bitcoins?
You know, I started Bitcoin in 2010, right? Mm-hmm. And I saw, like, you know, it was real cheap to buy Bitcoin back in the day. Now, you can see in the news what they say about Bitcoin.
Yeah.
It's a lot of money.
Yeah. Versus one American dollar, 66,000 right now.
Yeah. It's keep going up. Sometimes go up and down, but it's still going up every time.
Definitely. So, man, I'm gonna ask you a question, man, because you know a lot of people don't understand, you know, Bitcoins and it's just now getting American people start talking about it, but the crisis that happened in Venezuela with the changing of the president, people don't understand that you was one of the main people that helped a lot of people when it came to the Bitcoins and getting food.
Yeah, you know, I got farm here in DR, I got farm in Colombia, Venezuela, but I prefer Venezuela because the electricity is real cheap.
You know? Okay.
It's better than here. I use solar power in Colombia, it's so-so, you know.
So-so. So you basically hear that. So the thing is, because people be asking about crypto. And the thing is, especially in the United States, it's hard because the electricity bill is really high. So, you know, versus the computers running, the rigs and stuff, it's a lot of heat, a lot of electricity. And if the electricity too high, you won't be able to gain when it comes to the farming.
Yeah, to return the money is no good. It's better if you can buy solar panel there, you know.
Yeah.
And, you know, and have many batteries, but you're going to spend a lot of money buying battery too.
Yeah.
That's another problem.
Yeah. So this is the issue. In the U.S., it's going to cost you to build a decent rig, $1,500 per rig, then electricity. So it's kind of hard. You know what I'm saying? So in Venezuela, you know, you're able to make moves, you know. And the thing is, tell the people some of the places you got some of the rigs at across the countries.
Here in India?
No, not just in
India. Oh, in many countries? Yeah. I have only on three countries.
Okay.
They are here. Colombia and Venezuela. Okay. But I prefer Venezuela because it's real cheap, the electricity, real cheap.
Okay. You understand? Definitely. So pretty much you got them in three countries, man, you know, pretty much. Kind of give you an idea of, you know what I'm saying, the rigs and... All right, so, hey, check it out, man. I got a question for you. So, you pretty much, it's all about Bitcoin. But you got your Ethereum, you got the Dogecoin and different coins out here. What's your opinion on them coins?
I'm telling you, they are mainly so crypto around there, you know. But I prefer Bitcoin. I trust more Bitcoin.
Yeah.
Because Bitcoin was the first one, you know, I prefer that one.
Yeah. So you hear that. So you pretty much prefer Bitcoin because Bitcoin was the first coin. All these other coins they got going out, man, like, it's kind of almost like, the question is these coins going to really gain the power like they claim?
I don't know because, you know, they Bitcoin was the first one, you know, that's what I think, and nothing bad happened to me with Bitcoin. I invest the other day in the one that I'm going to resell the name, you know, and it's going down, you know, I prefer Bitcoin.
Yeah. So I prefer Bitcoin. So, you know, that just, you know, just coming live when the Bitcoin came, you know what I'm saying, doing this a long time, and I tell you. Yeah. So listen, man, I got a major question for you. Because I look at you as a made man, you know what I mean? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, your properties that you got, you know what I'm saying? Because I've visited you in a few facilities, and you got nothing but mansions, man. So, yo, what's your lifestyle, man? Like, you know?
My lifestyle, oh, man. I love to enjoy my life. I'm single, you know. I love Latin America most because they are the real freedom.
Real freedom.
You know, like in the state, you got to be working every day, you know, like a robot.
Yeah.
Here, I enjoy my life. I go to Venezuela, Colombia, Brazil, many countries in Latin America. I prefer Latin America more than Europe and North America.
Yeah. So you hear that? So he prefer Latin America more than the States. He know all about the United States, but he say you be working like a rabbit over there.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? So he pretty much, you know, and which he's a made man. You mind saying how much money you make when it comes to crypto?
Oh, man. Think about 2010.
Okay.
To now, 2021.
Okay.
But it's a secret. I'm going to say how much money it is.
Okay. So he don't want to let the secret out, so he'll keep that to himself. But the biggest thing is this right here, like Latin America, man. So I pretty much, man, it amazes me your lifestyle because every time I turn around, you jumping on the plane, and you just seem like you jump on the plane like how people go to their job every day.
Yeah, I feel sorry. You got to invest in Bitcoin. That's what it is. It's so easy. You are in the United States. You can invest a little bit. Try it. Invest.
But see, this is the issue in the U.S. right now. You only going to get a percentage of the Bitcoin. Keep fluctuating up and down. So the problem is they, you know, what I look at is it's too late to invest.
Yeah, it's real hard to invest, to buy Bitcoin, but you can invest maybe a little bit, and you can make a little bit of money. Then you try and see, you see, if you make a little bit of money, and then if you see it raising the money, invest a little bit more. Yeah. That's it. Yeah.
You know what though, man, and that sounds pretty good, but the issue is, man, honestly, it's almost like when they just now starting to talk about Bitcoins, that's the issue. See, like you deal with Cuba and all that. You got family stuff in Cuba and stuff too.
Yeah.
Yeah, so Cuba, you know, you was able to invest way before the word got out.
Yeah.
And that's the issue, you know what I'm saying?
That was the thing, dude. I think before that, you know, I start thinking, I think, you know, Bitcoin gonna raise, I gonna make a lot of money on Bitcoin.
Yeah.
I didn't have no money like that, but you know, I invest $2,000 the first time. In Bitcoin.
That's back in the day. So he invested $2,000 in Bitcoin back in the days. And that's back in the days. So, you know, that just...
Yeah, it's always imagine how much money I have. You know.
Well, I could tell you this much. And let's say Bitcoin at $60,000 per American dollar. So that's 2,000 times 60,000 right there.
Yeah.
So I see why you keeping it a little secret.
Yeah.
Word. So you know, this is a great interview. Keep
more and more, you know.
Yeah. That's deep, man. So, man, I tell you live and direct, the crypto king, man. So you know, I want to ask, you know, so.
And the good thing about Bitcoin too, you can, in many countries they got ATM for Bitcoin too.
But you know, see, this is the issue, especially for a lot of people in America. They didn't have the ATMs and stuff for the Bitcoins.
That's the use of it, you know. But in Latin America, here we got that. Yeah. You know, in other countries too, in Latin America. Yeah.
So listen though, I'm gonna tell you something. Your rig in Venezuela is crazy, man, because, man, I'm talking about the farm, man. You got so many computers running, man, like.
The farming, yeah.
Yeah, it's like.
Starbucks,
like 300 plus computers in there, man. Like,
yeah,
man, boy.
And people using more memory too, like yeah. to farming.
Yeah, farming.
It's more cheaper for electricity too.
Yeah. Well, you know what's so crazy? So they got big facilities in the U.S. now for the farming, man. But you know, it's almost set up for only the people with the big money to make it. You know what I'm saying? And you know.
Only for the big people to make it.
Yeah.
Well, they want you out of the game. They only want the rich now.
Yeah. Only want the rich. Yeah. But I tell you the truth, man. One day I wish I could get your lifestyle, man. Your lifestyle. Because I'm going to tell you the honest truth, man. I mean, you jump on the plane, man, like how people go to the grocery store, man, in my country.
Yeah, they bring me the grocery store. I'm like, I don't even gotta go to the grocery store. I call them, I need this and this. They bring me, I don't even gotta get out.
Yeah.
Got people working for me.
Yeah. So and that's the next level. So he got people working for him. He don't gotta do nothing. They bring everything to him. He move how he wanna move. Man, listen. Yo, the crypto king. So the crypto king, he live a lifestyle like a king. Latin America. The world is his. Pretty much he do what he want to do, how he want to do it. Yeah, it's deep, man. So, great interview, man. I appreciate the opportunity, man.
Yeah, the world is mine.
Yes, sir. Yes,
but
sir.
Legally.
Yeah, the world is
in a legally way. No, like, it's Scarface thing, you know.
You hear what he said? The world is his in a legal way. Not like Scarface now. Real talk. Crypto King, man.
Everything, buying thing, invest your money in Bitcoin. The world is yours.